The NGP, we found what that is.
Yes, PS Vita.
Sony?
The PSV.
Oh, yeah.
Maya. So that's what I'm going to call it, the PSV.
Or Vita, as Vida. Adam Sessler
just
freaking saying.
He kept screwing.
I think he was doing that on purpose.
Just to make fun of the name. Did they get it from, like,
it means life in Latin, I believe.
Yes, life in Latin.
That's cool. I guess.
I think they got it from Microsoft. They just got Vista and then took out this.
Vista?
Yeah.
This is old, though, man.
I know, I'm just saying, they just took off the S, and they're just like, hey, look what we did.
That's cool.
But, I don't know, when I was sitting there, and they were about to say the name, I was all excited. Like, I was, like, expecting something just, like, wonderful in my ears, and I heard Vita, I was just like, oh, ooh. But the more they said it, I really like the name now, so.
I was fine with PSP. I'm just going to call this one PSP.
Well, that's what I was wondering about the Wii thing, too, because, like, if you name it PSP again, like, no one's going to know it's a new system, like, you know?
Yeah.
Like, PSP Go, they could understand that's just, like, the revamped of the same thing. So if they name this one, like, PSP, like, U, something stupid like that,
yeah.
people aren't going to know, especially the casual, like, oh, it's probably the same thing. So that's how I look at it. I'm glad they came with a whole new name.
Yeah,
it
definitely separates it from the PSP.
Definitely.
Do you know, like, what the major difference between the PSP and the PS Vita is? Other than, like, they obviously has two analogs, multi-touch screen, a back touchpad, front and back cameras, Wi-Fi.
That's it, dude.
And
that's pretty much it.
3G.
3G, yeah, 3G.
They got a microphone camera in the front. I don't know if you said
what
that.
All did the PSP have, though?
The PSP, like, one of the major things that everyone's talking about is the dual analogs, because the first one, everyone's just like, we need the second one to be playing games.
That's the Sony trademark.
Yeah, so I know that's a huge thing. And then, like, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't think that's true.
I don't know. Everyone's raging. Because they can actually pour over games like Uncharted, and you can get the full Uncharted experience because you have the dual analogs. So, that, I don't know. For me, that's huge groundbreaking for me.
It's powered by AT&T.
Yeah.
For the 3G?
I've been with AT&T, at least for my internet and everything else, so I'm fine with them. Everyone always says they're slow and suck, but I haven't had troubles with them, so you can jump off a cliff, too.
Where we live, we don't have AT&T.
AT&T, yeah.
I have internet. Not.
Do we?
Yeah, I do.
We recently got it, didn't we?
I haven't had it.
I don't know. I've been seeing some AT&T shows around, so who knows.
Yeah. Well, one of our cell phone providers got taken over by AT&T also, so we do have iPhones here now.
Well, that's Verizon got iPhones too.
And then, but yeah, I mean, the 3G I like, and then, like, which was a good idea to have because a lot of people need things on the side, like, but it also raises the question, like, why don't you just get a cell phone also?
Yeah, exactly.
But
I'm not a handheld gamer. I mean, same. Don't get me wrong, I love Pokemon.
Yeah,
that's it.
Yeah, that's pretty much the only handheld game I've played.
Emulators. I really like how they...
Then a couple of the Zelda ones, which I thought was pretty fun.
I think what will really sell it is the way they incorporate with PS3s. Because I think the only reason people will get
that's the only good thing.
Because I was honestly tempted at points to get one because of the cool features PSP
had. How are they
going to
combine them?
I mean, it was simple stuff that I really wanted to do with my PSP and my PS3. Like, if you're, let's say, in a different place and you have internet connection, you can activate your PS3 from that location. Then from there, you can, like, play music from that PS3 system.
Now, Dan Mack, if someone wants to watch baseball, can you take it from your screen over your PS3 and put it on your Vita?
God.
Can you do that?
I don't know. I know you can do videos from, like, your PS3 system, but I don't know about the baseball thing. I'm going to have to get back to you on that.
I love me some baseball. You know
that. We gotta watch our baseball on the big screen.
We're so hardcore, we have to play.
Oh, man. Okay.
What about the price?
The price, I'm really glad that they set it right up next to 3DS, because I think that's what's always been killing Sony, is that they've had the most expensive.
Exactly.
And I think that's just how their brand is, because their brand for everything is most expensive. When you get a Sony, it's usually the richer people that really want to get the well-built
things. Because Sony does have amazing graphics.
Yeah.
That's why they're so expensive.
And, like, TVs, they make really good products. So I think
that's why they're more expensive. And a lot of times the price, like, detracts people. I still think, I don't know, I think the 3DS and the Vita are expensive for handheld.
I think
you can get an Xbox or a PS3
for that price. Add $50 more, you've got a system.
Yeah,
brand new one.
Well, what I'm saying is, like, I think for at least the Vita, they really lowered the price of what it could have been. That could have been easily over $300 system.
And it's a good price.
The 3DS, personally, I think is overpriced, but that's just me.
I agree on both, man.
I honestly think the Vita is a really good system. All the things they've added, well over 300. 3DS, it just looks too toyish for me. That's not saying I don't love Nintendo's handhelds either. Like, I love me some Pokemon also.
It's amazing.
So,
serious.
Yeah, I mean,
who doesn't?
Yeah, so, like, it's not that I hate it or anything. It's just I don't feel that they've added enough to justify that almost $300 price tag.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, I'm sure it's, I think the PS Vita is probably worth more, like, all the stuff they put inside it.
Yeah.
But
I know the crowd was excited to hell when they heard the prize. Everyone was
I think they were excited because it was with, it's like, you choose.
You
3DS
that.
Or Vita.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's your choice.
Because, like, I read some people, like, before they announced the prize, they were like, oh, this is going to be, like, $400 thing, like, blah, blah. It's like, they really shot down the price. Really nice.
Yeah.
So that's, I don't know, for me, that's going to raise the question on how much future systems are going to be if handhelds are getting this high in price. I think that $600 price tag that Sony started with is going to be something normal.
They need to have good games at release. Because the 3DS didn't. That's what hurt it really bad. It didn't have any of the games it, like, announced at launch.
And they do. They have what? They have...
they're getting them now.
Uncharted, Golden Abyss.
Oh, yeah.
Metal Gear.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm sure it'll do fine. I'm honestly, it's definitely going to sell.
Yeah.
Well, mostly because they have that
first month
advertising.
It amazing sales.
Well, they have that advertising going where you can bring in your old DSs and get a discount on the 3DS. So many people have.
Well, I have two.
Yeah, so it's like people are going to put in their old one to get a new one for a cheaper price. So,
yeah.
I don't know. That's really going to help them out. And Sony's not doing that, which I'm not saying is a bad
thing.
That's
disappointing.
That's really going to help out 3DS, though.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, it's not really your upgrade from, like, scratch. You can put a bit of a down payment on it.
The PSP played movies. Does the Vita?
I believe so. I know the, like, the show was all about downloading things.
It's most likely going to.
Because they have the store, and you can download from
the
video store, download from the game store.
So, the games, obviously, our first one is Uncharted Golden Abyss. What do you guys think?
My only biff on that, and honestly for the Vita itself, is they're going too much on the touchscreen. The gameplay
makes it look easy.
It's definitely easy in the game.
That's what
Morgan said on.
Yeah, she
was talking about
totally
it. I don't know if it was her that, like, replied to that, but they're like, after they, oh no, it was someone else that they brought on stage. But they said they didn't like the touchscreen thing because they were a hardcore gamer. But after a while, when they actually work with the touchscreen, because it helps just guide it, and they found that it was actually really nice to work with the touchscreen. So, I mean,
once again, I think it just takes away from the gameplay, which is what it's meant to do. It's supposed to be, you know, you playing, you controlling the guy, instead of just doing a little swipe and then having to do that whole sequence for you. Even with the combat, just touching the guy and having him fight for you, it's... I don't know. I think it just totally takes away from gameplay.
I agree.
And that's, I don't know if it's going to hurt it or not. A lot of people seem to think it was really cool, but my personal view, I think it's not good.
I don't know. I can't say it's not butter.
Yeah. I have to say,
sorry, go.
The graphics did look amazing.
Yes.
It looks like PS3 quality.
Well, they were ranting about how it's supposed to rival the first PS3 games, like, up there in graphics. So. But they also said it might kill the battery a bit. Battery power goes down right away. So I'm not really looking forward to that.
It's not
going to
be that portable then.
Yeah. Yeah, basically, you're going to be right next to a plug-in trying to keep that bad boy going.
What's another game for this Vita?
Well, if you do get a Vita, buy Pass or Rent.
I don't know. I really want to get it, mostly because I have a PS3. And I really like the functionality they had between the PSP.
Yeah, but you have
and
to buy two games. Two same games.
No,
this is a different game. This is Uncharted Golden Abyss.
Oh, I thought you were talking about
it's like another story.
Yeah, okay.
Not talking about just buying games. I just want to get it for the functionality with my PS3, so I don't have to keep it like bogged down with memory of like songs and videos. I can be somewhere else, because I do use my PS3 a lot, and it will be so much easier just to boot up my PS3 also, and then just start streaming from there. So
yeah,
that's the way I look at it, mostly because I have two PS3s, and it's just kind of like, yeah, it helped me just keep connected with them. So and I have a lot of buys too, so it'll just be nice to be able to
are you gonna get the game?
I don't know.
Uncharted.
I'd have to get a Vita first and then the game, but if I did have money, like somewhere just random, $240,
yeah,
I would definitely buy it.
You don't know how much the Vita games are going to be. If they're $60,
that's
ridiculous.
Negative, yeah.
Anyway, our next game is Ruin on the Vita, which I thought looked pretty cool. Other players are your rivals, and it's PS3 capable.
Yeah,
that looked really cool.
That's the one I was talking about, where you have to buy the separate game for the PS3, which I think is a total waste of money.
Do you have to buy it again?
Well, you have to buy one for the PS3 and then one for the Vita, and then you can take your gameplay, take your gameplay, put it up on cloud or whatever you guys use,
mm-hmm.
and then pull it up to your PS3 and use it. But yeah, you still have to buy that whole separate game, which is,
mm-hmm.
what, another $60?
If it's like that, that's kind of lame.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I have a feeling they're not
going
to make you buy the game twice just to do that.
How are they going to run the game, though?
You might, like, buy the game and the CD might come with it.
Yeah. Well, like,
that could be cool.
Like, Nintendo's done this before with, like, I don't know if you guys have DSs, but they have, like, a share connection. Like, so
yeah.
If I have the game and you don't have the game, you can still verse me in that game.
Yeah, I play that one.
Yeah.
Do you have to be connected, though?
Yeah, online.
Wi-Fi.
But no, but only
just
one
Wi-Fi.
Of you has to have the game to verse each other. You know what I'm saying?
Hmm.
So I'm thinking maybe like if you buy the CD version, I don't know if it'll come, because that's going to be a bit of a loss
that,
to them.
Yeah.
So I guess we could see.
Unless
how
like you can
out.
Just plug it in somehow. They give you
plug
like a
it,
USB
go, yeah.
you can plug it in.
And it reads
and
registers.
That takes away from the portability. You know what I mean?
Just like if you want to play on your PS3,
yeah.
on your big
like
screen,
if
you
were
you
to
can.
Just, like you get back home and you're like, oh, hey, 55-inch time. Let's plug this bad boy in.
I'm still.
If it's expensive, that's.
Right. I don't think people are gonna do it if it's expensive.
Yeah, but it does look like a really cool game.
Yeah.
I definitely would buy that.
Interesting.